Hello everyone, myself Mrs. Archana Mhatre, lecturer in Electronics and Telecommunication Department. In this video, we are going to continue with the fifth unit of basic electronics, that is regulators and power supply. In this video, we will see the Zener diode as a voltage regulator. So here, it is a circuit diagram. When the Zener diode will act as a voltage regulator, we have already studied the Zener diode and the characteristic of Zener diode. Now the voltage across the Zener diode remains constant, equal to VZ, that is Zener voltage, when it is operated in the Zener region of the reverse characteristic. So when the Zener diode is connected in a reverse reverse situation, then the Zener diode will act as a voltage regulator. Now here, this is the characteristic, reverse characteristic of a Zener diode. So here you can see, this is the reverse characteristic which is in third quadrant. Now here in this region where the straight curve is appear, in this region the Zener diode is act as a voltage regulator. So this fact is utilized in the application of a Zener diode as a voltage regulator. A voltage regulator circuit should keep the load voltage constant in spite of changes in its input voltage or load current and temperature. The series resistance RS is connected to limit the total current drawn from the unregulated DC supply. The Zener diode regulator is a shunt type voltage regulator because the control element, that is Zener diode, is connected in parallel with the load resistance as shown in the figure. The operation of the Zener regulator: the input voltage Vin is an unregulated DC voltage which is obtained from a rectifier filter combination. RS is the current limiting resistance and RL is the load resistor. The input voltage Vin should always be higher than the breakdown voltage VZ. The circuit diagram shows that the Zener diode is reversed biased and operates in the Zener region of the reverse characteristic. If Vin is higher than VZ, if the Zener current, that is IZ, is in between the IZ minimum and IZ maximum, then the voltage across the Zener will remain constant, which is equal to VZ, irrespective of any changes in the input voltage Vin and load current IL. As the output voltage is constant and equal to VZ, will get the regulated output voltage. Zener diode IZ should not be higher than IZ minimum, otherwise excessive power dissipation will damage the Zener diode. So the Zener diode Zener diode current, that is IZ, should always be lower than the IZ minimum. IZ should not be less than IZ minimum, either because then the Zener diode cannot operate in the Zener region and cannot maintain a constant voltage across it. The regulator should keep the load voltage constant in spite of changes in the input voltage and load current. Now here, the regulating action with the varying input voltage when IL is constant. If the input voltage increases, then the current I increases, but the IL is constant as IL is equal to VZ divided by RL. Hence the increases as IZ is equal to I minus IL. So if IZ is less than IZ max, then the Zener operates in the Zener region and output voltage remains constant. In second condition, if the input voltage will decreases, then total current I will be decreases. But the IL is constant, hence Zener diode current IZ will be decreases, and hence resultant, if the IZ is greater than IZ max, then the Zener operates in the Zener region and output voltage remains constant. Now next, transistor series regulator. This is a circuit diagram of a transistor series regulator. The basic series regulator circuit diagram is shown in figure. The transistor Q will act as a control element and it is connected in series with the load resistor RL. Here you can see this is a transistor which is connected in series with RL. It also acts as a variable resistor to control the output voltage. Zener diode, it provides reference voltage. Resistor R, it acts as a current limiting resistor. And base resistor RB, it provides the biasing for transistor Q to keep the transistor in the active region. The operation of the circuit is the transistor is operated in the active region and it is called as a series pass transistor. The series pass transistor operates in the emitter follower configuration. Therefore, the output voltage is given by VO is equal to VZ minus VBE, that is voltage from base to emitter. The VZ is the Zener voltage, therefore it is assumed to be constant. Therefore, if the output voltage varies, then there will be a change in the VBE because VZ is constant. Regulated action of this transistor series regulator is, if the output voltage increases due to some reason, then VBE, that is voltage from base to emitter, will decrease. Due to the reduction in the VBE, the base current decreases, therefore the collector current decreases. This will increase the collector to emitter voltage, that is VCE, across the transistor, and VO, that is output voltage, will be reduced till it reaches the desired value. This is because VO0, that is VO output voltage, is equal to VIN minus VCE. If the output voltage decreases, the exactly opposite action will take place and the output voltage is increased till it reaches the desired regulated value. So here the summary of the regulated action, that is the output voltage increases, then VBE decreases, then base current decreases, collector current also decreases, and voltage from collector to emitter increases, and as a resultant the output voltage gets regulated. In next condition, when the output voltage decreases, then voltage from base to emitter increases, then base current increases, because of that collector current also increases, and the output the voltage from collector to emitter decreases, and as a result V0 gets regulated. Now next we'll see the transistor shunt regulator. So here it is a diagram for shunt regulator transistor. The Zener regulator circuit is modified to obtain the transistor shunt regulator as shown in figure. The transistor Q acts as a shunt control element. It is operated in the active region. The operation of this circuit, from figure, the output voltage is given by V0 is equal to VZ plus VBE. VIN, that is input voltage, is the unregulated DC power supply sending a current II through the current limiting resistor R. Regulated action of this circuit is, the relation between the input current, collector current and load current is as shown below. I, that is input current, is equal to collector current plus load current. If the output voltage decreases due to any reason, then VZ plus VBE will also decrease. But VZ is constant, so VBE will decrease. This will reduce the base current IB of the transistor. This will reduce the collector current IC, so more current will flow through the load and the load voltage will increase. This will continue till the load voltage reaches the desired level. If the output voltage increases, then exactly opposite action will take place to regulate the output voltage. Now here again it is a summary for the regulator action of a shunt regulator. as output voltage decreases, Vz plus VBE also decreases. Then VBE decreases, IC decreases, because of that IL, that is load current, increases and output voltage will be restored. Now if the voltage V0 increases, then Vz plus VBE increases, then VBE increases, IC, that is collector current, increases, and because of that load current decreases and output voltage will be restored. Now next we'll see the comparison between the series and shunt voltage regulator. On the basis of these parameters, we'll compare the series voltage regulator and shunt voltage regulator. First parameter is control element. It's connected in series with load, and in shunt voltage regulator, it connected in shunt with the load. The output impedance of the series voltage regulator is low and shunt voltage regulator output impedance is high. The voltage regulation of series voltage regulator is better than the shunt voltage regulator. Then series voltage regulator is suitable for heavy loads while shunt voltage regulators are suitable for light loads. Then power supply current for series voltage regulator is same as load current, and the supply current of shunt voltage regulator is higher than the load current. Efficiency of the series voltage regulator is good for high load current, and efficiency of the shunt voltage regulator is good for low load current. Thank you.